Thanks, Jen. That's right. We're here with Bill Spetch. He is the Deputy Manager of the International Space Station Transportation Integration Office at NASA. Bill, thank you for joining us after the launch.
No problem.
It looks like a beauty from where we were watching it. You're obviously watching in a very official capacity. What's the official word from you?
Oh, no, it was a great launch. We were really happy to see the weather clear out the way it did. It was a little bit touch and go after yesterday and continuing to watch the forecast as we went, but the clouds cleared out and we got to see a great launch.
Yeah, it was 70% no-go yesterday. Got all the way up to the 624 launch point and had weather delays, so couldn't do it. Mm-hmm. But then 12 minutes later, it cleared.
Yeah, yes.
Could have launched. Today, same setup, 70%, but then the weather started to clear. Just in time, about an hour, all those weather constraints lifted, and it hit right on time at 6:01, right when you needed to.
Yep, absolutely. You know, it's an instantaneous launch window to get to ISS for this, and so they have to hit that time frame, and that's why we couldn't go yesterday with the weather the way it was. Even though it cleared out so quickly afterwards, you got to go right on time to catch up with the space station the way you need to.
Did you watch the launch live outside, or did you watch it on the monitors?
So we were over at the SpaceX Launch Control Center, and we were watching it. We ran outside to go watch it because you got to take a look at it outside. You don't really get the effect when you're in the building watching it on the monitors.
Yeah, it was just a beautiful launch all the way from start to finish, it seemed to us. How about that landing?
Man, it's impressive every time you see it. And you know, it was great to see this one land successfully, because we flew this booster on our previous mission. And so this has been one that we've used before, and, you know, we'll probably use again.
And the Dragon flying for the third time now, mm-hmm, to the International Space Station. Your thoughts on the 5,000 pounds of supplies and science that are going up?
You know, there's dozens of new investigations going up on this flight. I can't wait for it to get up there and for them to get started on it. A couple of really interesting ones that caught my eye as I was looking through it. They're looking at a space moss experiment, looking at growing moss in space and seeing how it develops differently than it does down here on Earth. And obviously that has applications as you look forward to exploring other planets and how did things grow. Another one that caught my eye, which is another one for terrestrial use, Goodyear Tire actually has an investigation going up on this one, looking at silica fillers and that can improve tire performance, improve gas mileage, and improve efficiency for our vehicles and help us out here on the ground.
And it bursts with the space station on Saturday. And
Saturday morning, yes.
They'll unload everything into the International Space Station. Your thoughts going forward, there is an international docking adapter that's, mm-hmm, also going up. It's berthing now with the current docking adapter. It's the same adapter, but now you'll have two places where the cargo spacecraft can dock?
Well, so this vehicle goes to the bottom port, the nadir port of the Harmony node, which is a berthing mechanism in this case of this vehicle. The docking adapter that we're bringing up will actually go on the top, and matches the one that we have on the forward of the space station that we docked the SpaceX Demo 1 mission to. And so this will enable us to now have two docked vehicles to the U.S. side of the station at the same time, allowing us to do crew handovers more efficiently and allowing them to talk to each other as they're exchanging things that are going on for one crew that's coming up and the crew that's leaving, to help really familiarize them with the vehicle and everything that's going on in the current status, live, face-to-face.
And how are you feeling after this launch?
Oh, it feels great. It feels really good. This is the 18th one for SpaceX under the CRS contract. We've got a couple more left with them under CRS-1, and then it's on to our CRS-2 missions. So it's great. We're really happy to get it going and look forward to getting it captured on Saturday morning.
Bill Spetch, thank you for joining us. Appreciate it.
No problem. Appreciate it.
That's going to wrap it up for us here at Hangar AE. We'll toss it back to Jen in the studio.